Oh my god.
Okay, so this is like my first video or whatever. And I didn't plan it. I just was like, you know what? Just gonna turn the camera on and things are gonna go. I don't know the way they were supposed to. I made dinner. I'm just eating and I just figured I'd have you guys here while I'm eating and I'm just gonna talk. Oh, this is mango juice. My fave. You probably can't read that because, but it's mango juice. It's lit. I'm gonna drink from the bottle. Because I live alone, it's my juice, so. Oh, I wanted to get some water. Oh, I made spaghetti.
Spaghetti and meat sauce. Oh God.
Yes, you can see that.
It's a bit tomato-y. I don't know, it's like
I
I
probably
use like the can.
tomato sauce. Well, not tomato sauce. I use the can.
Spaghetti sauce, and it had meat
flavored. I figured it would taste like meat, but
it just tastes like tomatoes in sauce, whatever.
tastes good, but whatever.
So, this is probably like the first time
I'm cooking for the month. No, I lied. Last week I made.
No, this was earlier this week. No, this week just started. This weekend, probably like
Saturday, I mean, which was last week.
I made sweet potato fries, fail, and some
Fish?
it tasted good, but they weren't fries, so I'm like, there was a dip.
So I put them in the oven.
Okay.
Cut them up. I cut the sweet potato up fine. It was lit. And then, like, spread it out. Put some seasoning on it. Put some oil on it. Put it in the oven. Like, these is gonna.
This is just gonna come out perfect, right?
Put them in the oven. I check it, like, 15 minutes in. I'm like, potatoes, they're not gonna take that long. So, 15 minutes in, they were cooking. They weren't soft yet, but I could still, like, I could tell that they were cooking. I don't know why it didn't like occur to me like they're potatoes. If you want fries, you fry them. They're gonna turn out like potatoes, like if you put potatoes in the oven. I don't know why that didn't occur to me, but it didn't. So I put them in the oven. 15 minutes later, I was like, okay, they're cooking, whatever. Leave them in there for another like 15 minutes, 30 minutes. Not bad. They should be crispy and all that stuff. I don't know what I was expecting. So like a good 10 minutes later, I smelt something burning and I'm just like, they're just
Being
crispy.
up.
It's nothing, but we can still check on them. So the bottom, the whole bottom of the whole tray of sweet potato fries was burnt. Like I could smell it. It was
Burnt. And like the
fries were just like baked potato. Like it was just soft and like if you mush it, it's mashed potato. Like it was a fail.
Mean, it tasted kind of
good, but like the burntness was just it was not working. And then the fish, I breaded it too much, so I like dipped it in the egg mixture, and then I dipped it in the bread, I mean in the flour mixture, but then I dipped it in the egg again and then dipped it. The double dipping was a fail. It was overbreaded. And then it was the meal, I don't know. I had expectations here, and it was just like it wasn't even on the scale. Like it was just a fail. So this actually tastes good though. This actually, this is like the quickest thing and the easiest thing for me to make, 'cause I'm always making it, spaghetti and meat sauce. Spaghetti and meat sauce. Like thaw the ground beef out, throw it in the frying pan, get some seasonings.
Get the sauce.
That's it. You boil your pasta. Pasta is the quickest thing.
I was supposed to be getting water. Oh, if you hear
anything, it's my cat, Ava. My kitten, actually. I got her 2 weeks ago. She's very
kitten-like. Let's just say that. I'm gonna get some water.
Oh, God. So rude.
I'm gonna get some water, okay?
Be right back.
I'm back.
I didn't realize I didn't even introduce myself. Like, who do I think I am? Like, oh, my name's Santino. I'm just about to say I'm 19. I'm 20. Been 20 for like 2 weeks. Oh God. I'm from the Bahamas, but I'm studying at the University of the West Indies in Barbados.
I don't know, a lot of people who
don't know about the Caribbean probably think like,
is that like in Jamaica or
something? And then I would just be upset, but oh God. But yeah, Barbados is like 5 hours from the Bahamas. I didn't know anything about it before I came here, so if you don't know anything, if you didn't even know it exists, we were in the same boat.
It's okay. It's pretty chill, like really slow
here. Everything basically shuts down like at like 6 p.m. So it's an island. It's not bad. I don't mind because I'm pretty lazy and I fit in.
I'm studying. Oh God. Who eats it? I don't want to talk with food in my mouth.
I also want to continue because I don't want to stop talking. And then, okay.
Okay. I'm going to eat when I'm done because obviously this is not going to work. Oh yeah, I'm studying at the University of the West Indies.
Okay, this is going to be
a whole thing. So I'm studying
currently political science with international relations. Every time I say that, everybody's like, oh, you want to be a politician? Oh, yeah, that's cool. Or they're just like, what? Because it's like so long and it's just like, okay, that must be intense and you must be really smart. You know, go ahead. I want to switch my major. I've been here for 2 years, mind you.
Going on 3. This is like, I'm
in my third year now. I want to take, I don't know what I want to take. But I think I want to switch my major to management with finance. One semester ago, I had like a whole thing where I was just like, oh my God, this is not what I want to do. I don't know what I want to do. I need to get out of here. I need to stop. I need to go home. I need to figure my life out. Figure my life out. So I went home and I was just chilling home for a bit, and then I was just like, I want money. Like, I need to get a job. So I got a job at a bank back home, and it was pretty cool, the bank job. I liked it because I liked having like something to do. I like having a purpose, like go to work, wake up, I actually have something to do, I have some place to go, I'm getting paid for this. I go to work and do what I have to do. I'm not a lazy person, so if you give me something to do, I'm gonna do it. Like, it's fine. So work was fine, but then like coming down, I realized like, I don't know, I didn't like the atmosphere at that particular job place. So I was just like, okay, maybe I finally know what I want to do now. I'll go back to school and I'll do management with finance. Management because working there, I realized like, okay, I wasn't at like I wasn't doing an entry level job, but I was like at the job right above it. And I realized, like, I don't know, things are so hectic when it comes to you doing, like, entry-level jobs, and you have to basically do everything because it's, like, you're trying to work your way up. Management, because I don't want to be working my way up. I want to be at the top. I just want to be at the top. I mean, you might have to work your way up from, like, a higher position and then, like, get to the, like, from, like, the second highest position and get to the highest, which is fine for me, but, like, working from the bottom, I can't. So I was like, you know what, I need to be the boss. If I don't get a job and become the boss, then I want to be my own boss. I'll make my own business, and that's always been a thing for me. Like, I've always wanted to have my own business, so management is something that I need, which is fair. And then I said finance because working in the bank, bruh, let me tell you, the money that you are getting, like, it's not like you work in, like, this is your first, that was actually my first job. It's not like, I don't know, for a first job, I was like, wow, okay, maybe I could work here for the rest of my life. Because if this is what the second rank person
is getting paid, bruh.
So I was like, I'ma need to get a little finance in there, because working in a bank seemed like a pretty cool job, but commercial banking, I can't deal. I can't deal with like the face-to-face with customers and people complaining about things that they don't even know anything about. And they're saying, oh, this is a problem, but it's not really a problem because you're just not paying attention to your bank account and stuff like that. I just can't. So I would prefer to like work more of a behind the scenes job, or like I said, be the boss. You don't have to deal with face-to-face customers. You have people that will do that. And like, or like say offshore banking or stuff or something like that. And I figured, you know what? I could have finance as I just need it in my life. I need it in my life. If you making this much money with a finance job, we can move on. So I said management with finance is fine. If I don't like it, at least I still have management there and I could fall back on that, start my own business or whatever. So I left work and I came here. I also wanted to save up enough money to get my own apartment and pay my own school fees. I don't know. I just was having a moment, and so I saved up, I think, enough money that I thought would pay for my school fees and pay my rent, and so that was fine. I got here, and mind you, I've been here before, so like I still have friends here and stuff like that. So it's just like a back at it again kind of thing. Classes aren't so bad. Like the math classes, though, seeing that I haven't done math since like 12th grade. And this is like my third year in college. It's like, whoa, what is this? Which is expected. But for somebody that doesn't go to class like all the time, it's kind of like, it's expected. But if you know that it's gonna be a difficulty, you go to class, you try to understand or whatever. Yeah, whatever. Okay. And so, right now, I still don't know what I want to do. I think I want to do management with finance, and I can't. Big thing right now. I'm still, like I said, studying political science with international relations. That's what my major still is. Because I returned to school in the second semester, you're not allowed to,
switch your major in the middle of an
academic year, which I guess makes sense. It makes sense. So I'm basically still doing, my major is still my political science with international relations, but I chose to do like
whatever management
courses I could. And there is no guarantee that I'm going to get approved to switch to management, which is just like, okay, 17.
It was just a pretty dumb decision. Like, you're taking these courses, but they're not really,
you can't really use them if you don't get it. Like, you're still stuck with this whatever. But I feel like I'm gonna get in, and if I don't, I still have a few courses that would help me in life. Like, I mean, maybe it won't help me like with this particular degree. It's not like I'm following that degree path anyway, but it'll help me in life. Like math, I'm doing microeconomics. I've done it before in high school, so it's not that bad, and I actually like the course. I lied. I like the teacher. He's cool. He makes it fun and funny, which is hard to find when you're in university, because lecturers are pretty uptight. They're just like, yeah, I'm here to do my business. I'm going to tell you this. This is what I know. Reading out this book, showing you this PowerPoint, and that's it. But he makes it funny. He tells cool jokes related to real life and stuff like that, which is perf. What other course? Management Information Systems, which is, it's fairly okay. I mean, it's basically like high school information technology, but like a step up. Like, it's just like, okay, we're gonna tell you a little bit more about what you did in Access, in Microsoft Access back in high school. So it's manageable. But my thing is, it's an easy course, but because it's so easy, they try to encrypt everything, like make it like this is some secret code language that you will only understand if you come to lectures. Like, you won't get it, and when you like figure it out and you like take hours to decipher what they're asking, they're just like, oh, can you make a table and then make sure you have like 3 field names and like 5 records in it? That's all you need to do. I'm just like, why didn't you just say that? That makes so much more sense, but it's whatever. I'm neither here nor there. I mean, I'm just trying to pass the class here, so it's whatever. So that's school. But I just turned 20 like 2 weeks ago, and I don't know, I'm in this space where it's like I've been on this earth for 2 decades now. What am I doing? Like,
what have I done?
And I don't know, like, I have no answer to that. I have no answer to, I mean, yeah, there are things that I've done, like, I've traveled with family, though, like, it's never been like, oh my god, I want to go to the Dominican Republic, let me just buy a ticket and go. That's never been, I want to, but it's never happened. And I felt like, in a space, when I was working at the bank, it was like, all this money that's coming in, I could just don't go back to school. I could just not go back to school. Just travel and just live a simple life. Like, I don't have to be the boss. I don't have to be like, I could just live this life here that I have now. And that would have been great. I mean, I feel like part of me still holds on to that, like, I could just go back and like forget this whole school thing and just make a life without getting a degree. I'm pretty sure people have done it before. And I guess they have. And maybe if I do, that'll be fine for me, but I don't know yet. And so I turned 20 and I'm just like, I was really upset with myself. Like, my birthday went by and like, it wasn't a celebration for me. It was more like a, oh my God, Santini, you've been here for 20 years. What the fuck have you done? Sorry if you don't
curse or you don't like
cursing. And I sat down in my room and I was like listing off the things that I've done. I'm like, oh yeah. You graduated preschool, you graduated elementary school, you made it to high school and you graduated that too. You did a pageant and I don't know, you've been, I guess, a good daughter or a child to your parents, and you basically followed everything that you're supposed to do in life. Like, you went through high school, you went to college, you've just been doing everything that you're supposed to do, but is that what you want to do? And also, like, why not do other things? Like, you're doing what you're supposed to do, but there are people.
And if you want to be.
Oh, my battery's dying. That's why something I just randomly popped up on my screen. And, like, in my head, it's like, if you want to be the boss, if you want to be someone outstanding, then why are you just still following, like, the normal path, like, that normal people go through? Like, it doesn't make any sense. Like, if you want to be extraordinary, you do extraordinary things. Except I'm scared. I don't know. Like, I feel like I'm, I guess, afraid that, like, I'm gonna take the leap and do extraordinary things, or try to do extraordinary things, and then I'm just gonna fail. Like, I'm just gonna be like,
oh God, I should have
just stayed in school, get my degree, and then, you know, followed the path that life was pointing out for me, but I just wanted to go on the unbeaten path, and this is what happens. Like, go to this random country and then like I get robbed and I have no money to get home, and my parents are just like, well, if you were in college we would have helped you out. But I mean, my parents aren't like that, but I'm just saying, like, what if life just doesn't work out? And I'm like, okay, well, maybe you can take the extraordinary things in strides. Like, how about not only be here for school, how about you do, like,
I don't know, take journeys,
explore the country. I mean, you're in a different country, you're not home, so that's kind of different. A lot of people just go to college in their home city or in their hometown or anything like that. But you took at least you did something, okay? You did something. So I was like, you know what, how about every Sunday you just catch a bus, because we ain't got no car out here, fam. Money ain't that good. So you take a Meryl Streep. Oh God, okay, sorry. I'm sorry. Anyways, take a bus. Just take an adventure. Maybe on these adventures you'll meet people and you'll, you know, like, things will point their way out to you. Maybe you'll find something that you like doing and you'll keep doing it every Sunday. Or you'll meet somebody and you'll go out with them and have lunch. Or they'll introduce you to somebody and you start networking and networking and you meet people and life just happens. But if you're sitting in your house, going to class sometimes, you're just doing the school thing and that's all you're doing, you're not really experiencing life. And I felt that way, and I was just like, you know what, maybe you should live your life. You've been here for 20 years, you should start living at some point. So I think that's what I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna bring you guys along with me. So this YouTube thing is another experience that I'm branching out. It's a part of networking. I want to meet new people from different countries. Like, you guys can hit me up and stuff, like, if you want to come. If you don't, it's fine. I understand. I watch millions of YouTube videos, and I barely ever comment. Like, I've commented on the millions of YouTube videos that I've watched, I've commented on probably 5. And that's because I'm always like, they're not even gonna see my comment. It doesn't even, they, and the point is, when I do comment, no one ever replies anyway. So it's like, yeah, I knew it was gonna happen. But if you comment, I will answer you, okay? I will answer. I feel like this video is getting too long, and I feel like you know me a little bit more. So if you want another video, just put a comment down below. Just let me know what you want to see. And if you just want to see me talking and kind of trying to eat, then you can just like the video, and I got you. I'll make another. I like to talk, even if it feels like I'm talking to myself, but I like to talk, so see you next week.
Wow, you actually made it to the end. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.